Yeah, let us start simple equations today, or simple equations are also called as linear equations. So the problems are of different kinds of models and all. Now this, the sum of three consecutive terms is 45. So first of all, whenever the sum of three consecutive terms is 45, let us assume them as x, x plus 1, x minus 1. So whenever is x minus 1, x and x plus 1, to make the solution of it makes simple. So is equal to 45. So whenever it is like this, we can clearly say that minus 1 plus 1 gets cancelled and x is equal to 15. So whenever x is 15, by how much is the difference between the squares of the extreme? First of all, whenever x is 15, the before number is 14 and the after number is 16. So it is 16 square, because it's by how much is the difference between the squares of the extreme terms. Squares of the extreme terms is 16 square, 14 square, more, whenever it is used more, so this is more than the square of the difference between the extreme terms, that is 16 minus 14 whole square. So it is a square minus b square, it is in the form of a square minus b square, a minus b 2 into 16 plus 14 is 13, minus 16 minus 14 is 2, 2 square is 4. So it is very clear, 2 into 30 is 50, 50 minus, sorry, 2 into 30 is 60, 60 minus 4 is 56. Therefore, what is your resultant answer? 56. And second option is your answer. So this is the one model of simple equations or linear equations using one variable, only one variable. Now, this is about a kind of a tricky question in TCS kind of a model. What is the tricky over here is that the lengthiest part of the question with the differentiation of T1, T2 and all. So now there are two trees. Let us assume the two trees as two trees, T1 and the other tree as T2. Whenever there are two trees like that, the condition is given if one monkey jumps from T1 to T2. So let us assume the total number of monkeys on T1 is T1 itself and the number of monkeys on T2 is T2 itself. Now one monkey is jumping from T1 to T2. So from T1, one monkey is jumped to T2. So definitely one monkey is added to T2 on each tree, then they are said to be equal. That is what the condition given. Let us mark them as equation number 1. Now, if one monkey jumps from T2 to T1, from T2 that monkey is jumping to T1. Now what happened? The number of monkeys on T1 would be double. So whenever one monkey is said to be jumping from T2 to T1, for T1 one monkey is added. For T2, one monkey is subtracted. Now mark this as equation 2. The best way of solving is definitely get to the options. So the very clear, the options, one particular monkey is jumping to the other and the other monkey is jumping towards this side. In this, in the second equation, there is a condition. It is double the number. I'm very sorry. So whenever it is like that, this particular first tree T1 is having double the number. So double the number, that is very important. So double the number is what T1 is having. That is the first tree. After once T2, the number of one monkey has been jumped to T1. Now for this we need to have a proper solution. Like whenever one monkey is jumped from T1 to T2 and one is added over there, they said the particular condition is equal. So using this particular logic, the first thing that we need to know, the difference between the two particular trees, the number of monkeys should be only 2. So but here the option, in the first option, the number of monkeys is, the difference is 4. Here it is 1. Now take the third condition, the difference is 2. In the fourth condition, the difference is 2. But who should be greater? Definitely according to the first equation, T1 should be greater. So here T1 is greater. Therefore, what is your answer? 7, 5. If at all you want, you can substitute. 7 minus 1 is 6. 5 plus 1 is 6. 6 and 6, they are equal. Take this T1 as 7. 7 plus 1 is 8. 5 minus 1 is 4. 4 into 2 is 8. Got. That's how you can solve the problems whenever this kind of models of questions are being given. Check. We'll check the next model. Now, fraction. as soon as you're talking about a fraction, fraction is nothing but a rational number, anything in the form of p by q. In this p by q, let us assume a fraction, numerator, a denominator. Numerator is n and the denominator is d. One is added to both the numerator and the denominator. One is said to be added to both the numerator and the denominator. Then what is the fraction? The fraction is 2 by 3. If one is subtracted from both the numerator and the denominator, one is subtracted from the numerator and the denominator, then what is the fraction? 3 by 5. So this is equation 1. This is equation 2. We have 4 options. Let us substitute those options for the numerator and denominator. So it is very again clearly visible. If at all it is 1 is added, it should be in the form of 2 by 3. 1 is subtracted, it should be in the form of 3 by 5. So let us take the first option, 11 by 7. 11 plus 1 is 12. 7 plus 1 is 8. 12 by 8. 12 by 8 is 3 by 2. So, but what is the, according to the first equation, it should be 2 by 3. It cannot be 3 by 2. So, as soon as you got a particular idea, like whenever you are substituting 11 by 7, you are getting 3 by 2 and your resultant is 2 by 3, you can see the third option, it is 7 by 11. So, as soon as you can see and crack that kind of a way, usually you can mark the answer as 7 by 11. If at all you want, you can substitute and see. 7 plus 1 is 8. 11 plus 1 is 12, 8 by 12, 8 by 12 is 2 by 3. Satisfied. Let us see the second condition. 7 minus 1 is 6, 11 minus 1 is 10, 6 by 10, 3 by 5. Satisfied. So no need to check the second and the fourth options. So this is how, when you do more number of questions, you can get through these kind of logics and all. And we'll see the next model. Yeah, good. A, B, C and D have 150 rupees among them. So now there are four variables, A, B, C and D. The total sum with them is 150 rupees. Condition is given, A has an equal, has an amount equal to, A is having an amount equal to whatever B and D are having. C has half what A has. C has half what A has. Actually, this is more than enough to find out what is the answer exactly. Why? Because as soon as you can find out that what is A is equal to B plus D, C is equal to half of A, many people think that, okay, half of A, we can get through the options and find out what is half of A. But there is one more statement given. B has the same amount more than C has, as C has more than D. So this is very important. So, according to the given condition, B is having the same amount more than C. Means, more than C it is, B is having the same amount, what is having more than C, as C is having the same amount more than D. More than D. This is what the condition is. So, if at all you are about to aware about the condition, you can use, you should use this condition and then later on you can find out. Let us use A is equal to B plus D and C is equal to half A, or A is equal to 2C. From this we can also say that A is equal to 2C. So let us substitute A is equal to 2C in the first, from the first equation. This is the first equation. From the first equation, A is equal to 2C. B plus D is there. B plus D is 2C. Why I am saying B plus D is 2C? Why? Because B plus D is equal to A. A is nothing but equal to 2C. Now, we have already C. So, observe from here also B plus D. Here also B, again minus D comes inside is plus D. B plus D is 2C. So, this is how the condition can be used. That's what we have written over here. B plus D is 2C. This is equal to 150. So, what is 5C is equal to? 150. So therefore, what is C is equal to? 30. Observe where is C is equal to 30. That is in the first option. That can be your answer. Next question. Time and distance with simple equations. This is how one more tricky kind of a question. Now the question is going like this. It's in 5 hours, A walks 4 miles more than B does in 8 hours. So let us assume A is walking A miles per 1 hour. B is walking B miles in 1 hour. In 5 hours, A walks 5A. In 8 hours, B walks 8B. In 8 hours, B walks 8B. But how many more miles? 4 miles more. So it is 4 miles more. Yeah, this is 8. There's some technical problem. This is 8b plus 4. Now in 7 hours, B walks 2 miles more than A walks in 3 hours. So 7 hours B walks, so 7 into B, 2 miles more. 2 miles more is plus. A walks in 3 hours. So this is one equation and this is the other equation. 5a is equal to 8b plus 4 and 7b is equal to 2 plus 3a. Now how many miles does A walk per hour? He's asking, he can walk how many miles per hour? If at all, A needs to be found out, it should be exactly a factor of 4. Observe, that is the only thing that we can do. 5A is equal to 4 into 2B plus 1. So it should be definitely divisible by 4. So what is the answer? 4 miles. Why? Because that is the only number which is exactly divisible by 4. So this is how you need to think out whenever you are solving this kind of competitive examination questions. So this is how you can solve, rather than solving the first equation and again second equation, solving each of them and all. This is the best way of solving.